Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Straight Talk, our 10-minute motoring talk show. I have with me my two associate editors, Dinzo Tabamo and Paolo Subido. Guys,
hi, good afternoon.
Hey everyone, and we're going to be talking about motorsports and the biggest motorsports event that's happening in the Philippines now, the Toyota Vios Cup. And we have a very special guest with us today. She is one of the very lovely, lovely drivers who's racing in the Vios Cup now. Let's all say hi to Miss Joy Spring.
Yay!
Hola! Oh, now I can. Yeah, hi! Hello!
Madami kang fans sa office, ang daming gustong sumama eh. Parang super. Kaya lang, ayaw payagan ng print managing editor. Ang daming deadline. Yung art director namin, sobrang fan mo.
Oh, cute.
And
thank you.
You look really great when you did this for us.
Thank you very much. That was one of the funnest shoots ever.
But, Joyce, can you tell us about your social media? Sobrang kang popular sa social media. One time, nag-post kami ng photo mo sa Facebook namin. Grabe yung virality. Nagulat ako. Medyo sanay na ako sa mga viral. Pero nung pinost namin yung sa'yo, grabe. Paano ka ba naging sikat sa social media?
I don't know because I really started with TV. So parang nakakagulat din na biglang. Siguro kasi mahilig talaga ako sa social media. I like uploading stuff. And even before I did TV, I was really fascinated with the power of social media. Like how you can get in touch with people through social media. Tsaka pwede kang mabuhay through social media alone, di ba? Like as vloggers have flourished in this industry. So, ayun, ewan ko. Siguro, kasi parang friends ko sila, I don't see them as fans. So, parang mas siguro mas close-knit community.
And cars, paano ka na-involved sa cars? Have you always been into cars?
No, but when I was in college, my boyfriend at that time had a car restoration company where they got vintage cars and they restored it. So, yung mga sira-sira talaga. So, they order parts from different countries and have it. So, ang first dream car ko before was a Shelby Cobra.
Wow.
Na sobrang yung I saw before he restored a parang teal colored 64 na Shelby Cobra and I was just like,
wow, that. That's crazy. Joyce, yeah. Tell us about when you got invited to, I know that you were the host first, I think, and then they invited you to join the Vios Cup. And what was your reaction to that?
I was surprised because as I mentioned in this article from Top Gear, I didn't know how to drive manual at first.
Right.
And so, I love sports, motorsports, and extreme sports in general. So, I used to do wakeboard and all that stuff. So, sabi ko sa mga folks from Toyota, oh, kunin nyo naman ako. May celebrity division pala kayo eh. Ganyan, whatever. So, it started out as a joke. And they're like, oh, sige, tara. Practice ka one time.
So, you're the type na parang try everything once.
Yeah.
And it's very complicated when you're actually driving a race car. And you guys had hardcore lessons, I'm sure.
Uh-huh.
And there are lots of techniques that you know. So, can you heel and toe? Can
yes.
you do all of those things? Na master mo na?
I actually am surprisingly very good at heel and toe.
Wow, that's fantastic.
But that's because I have huge feet. I have a size 9 for women.
So, dude, that's
which
a big,
is so
that's,
weird,
that, that's a really big deal. That's a very sexy thing, man. But I have to ask you, okay.
It rolls long.
So guys think that, you know, girls who race cars are really hot, right?
Uh-huh.
Do you think guys who race cars are hot too?
Oh my
Did
gosh,
you find it a turn
yes.
on? Yes.
Or guys in general who know their cars and like their cars. I mean, I think, you know, and not to sound like we're siding or anything, but when you see nice cars and guys who actually set it up or know how it got there or actually fix it and take care of it well, you're kind of medyo impressed.
May extra.
Diba?
Okay. But what if that guy was racing on the street?
Maybe not.
Yeah, that's right.
Maybe not.
Irresponsible.
I mean, that's very irresponsible. That's right. I think that's not only irresponsible to yourself, but also to people who don't know what's happening. And I live in the area of White Plains, so I'm too
lots
familiar
of
with
drag
that.
Racing that happens there.
Lots and lots of drag racing.
Speaking of race drivers, pinapatanong ng readers namin to, pero biro, tinatanong nila kung may dinidate ka na raw. May dinidate ka raw na race
wala
car driver.
Wala Wala. As in, wala.
Talaga?
As in, ba? Sino ba yung tinatanong nila?
Alam namin
alam
yung
may
going
out
with
iniisip
the race car driver.
Sabihin mo na, sino yung specific
sobrang
na iniisip mo?
Sobrang guwapo na race car driver.
Sino ba? Si Poland Dumlao, ganon. Si Poland pa yung naano yung nadama yun, no?
But this year ka lang natuto talaga mag-manual?
Yeah, this year lang.
Wow, hanap naman.
Technically, January. That was the first time I joined the level 1 class of TRS. Tapos, yung sabi ni JP to us, oh, sino dito hindi marunong mag-manual? Kasi if the racing is pretty, it's pretty simple if you know the techniques. But first, you know how to drive manual. Eh, wala yung nagtaas ng kamay, so parang ako, nagtago na lang ako sa gilid. Tapos after a while, I talked to JP and to my coaches, and I was like, can you please teach me?
So which do you prefer now, manual or automatic?
Manual.
Honestly?
Honestly, manual.
Okay, so you're driving a manual now, your personal car?
No, well, yeah, I have a manual car.
Okay.
But for every day, it doesn't make sense to have a manual car in Manila.
Sobrang
I'd
traffic.
Like to think, yeah, sobrang traffic.
What was your realization when you learned how to drive manual and race in the VS Cup?
I became a responsible driver. And I also appreciated cars better because when you drive manual, doon mo talaga mapupush yung power ng kotse and you really understand why people tend to fall in love with cars the way they do. You know, like they set it up, they fix it up. And I just really became a more responsible driver. And I guess, you know, what my friends would think na parang, oh, dapat mas mabilis ka na mag-drive ngayon kasi racer ka na, whatever. Pero baliktad eh.
It's the opposite, yes.
It's the opposite, di ba? Because parang yung mga sinasabi ni JP na, where you look, that's where you'll go. Mang ganun, you become more sensitive about those things and then you become more respectful to other drivers and you become more patient. Because I think if anything, racing is paradoxical in a way where it doesn't require you to be ha ha ha. It requires to be to kind of just slow it down and figure it out slowly instead of, you know.
Joyce, what's your favorite thing about getting, you know, wearing the helmet, wearing the suit, getting behind the wheel of a race car? What's the best feeling?
The best
feeling?
Thing?
Yeah, what's the best thing about it?
Is feeling cool. Just kidding. Sobrang cool ng itsura mo, di ba?
Oh, especially the suit fits really well.
The suit fits me really well, surprisingly.
Most memorable moment sa VS Cup for you, on track.
On track, I started my last race at the last position. I ended in fourth.
Wow. How many were you?
We were eight, I think.
Okay.
Yeah. Eight or seven.
That's good.
So, and nakakatawa ko, Sam YG, one of the celebrity racers as well, and sila Ferdy Ong, came up to me, kalat ako nung qualifying. And always, I don't know, for some reason, I'm always kalat pag qualifying. Sabi nila, hoy, anong ginawa mo nung qualifying? Para daw ako nag-sandbag. Sabi ko, guys, hindi ako sandbagging. It's just because it's a street race. So, of course, qualifying, hindi mo nangangapa ka pa, diba? So, come race day, I was like, okay, alaw ko na to. So my race lines are okay na. So that was my favorite part.
Which celebrity right now sa Philippines na parang gusto mo makalaban sa racetrack na hindi pa nagde-drive sa Toyota VS Cup?
Oh my gosh. I think Ryan Aguncillo would be really cool.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, Kuya Ryan.
He drifts.
I know he drifts, diba?
Meron yata siyang contract with another brand, di ba? Or tapos na. Parang...
Well, oh, parang nga, no?
Meron.
And Yellow Cab, I think.
Yes. Mm. So, baka may contract doon.
Baka may ano.
Tell us about the next race. Is it gonna be held sa Clark ba?
Yeah.
Okay.
Subic.
Well, sorry, Subic.
The next is Subic.
Subic para, not Clark.
Subic. Are we allowed to say now where it's going to be at?
Sugata-san said so. So, it's
okay,
kind of official.
So, it's gonna be in the old airport.
If I'm
not mistaken, I think. And it's going to be really exciting because the lanes are going to be wide. So, I guess it's more of going to be technique more than
anything.
Yeah,
may overtaking na.
Oo, may overtaking na. So, kailangan mo nang alaman kung paano gumagana talaga yung kotse mo. Hindi na pwedeng you got lucky because somebody hit a wall or a barricade. It's gonna be really precisely about techniques and everything else.
So. Did Sam YG give you some tips?
Oh yeah.
Why
do you ask?
Because he's one of the best racers on the grid.
Yes, and we're from the same radio station. Yon. Really good friends. Yeah.
Parang may insinuated.
Wala namang dapat yun. No, but Sam is actually one of the.
He's a good driver. Man.
Yeah, he's a really good driver. He's one of the first people to really teach me about may mga secrets na binibigay sa kanya.
Meron ka bang rituals before you get into the car, the race car?
One of my coaches also told me to sit inside the car 30 minutes before and just visualize the track and how I would get it. So that's what I do. I don't hang around friends or you know, in the tent. I sit in my car for 30 minutes before suiting up, and then I visualize the track and how I would take it, which gear, how I do my turns,
This is very advanced stuff. You have a pretty good coach, huh?
Thank you.
Yeah. Actually, who is it? Stuart.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, Stuart and Arrow. Arrow is actually the head of our security for VS Cup, but he races motorcycles.
Okay.
Sorry.
Our time is up.
What? what?
Yeah. Sorry, like we told you, this is just really 10 minutes.
Yeah.
Guys, you want to say something to our readers who are your fans as well?
Well, I just wanted to say hello and thank you once again for having me and for being there even during my Vioscop experiences. It really is, aside from, you know, all of the big hulabaloos, it really comes down to the people who you see on the track and who you see on social media supporting you and cheering you on even if they don't get to watch. So thank you very much, Topi, and to everyone who keeps on sending me photos of my feature from months ago.
You want to invite them next for the next race?
Yes, we'll see you November 26th to 28th, I think is the
weekend. Is that really final?
I'm not yet sure, but we'll see you this November.
Last
week of November for the last leg of Vioscop 2015. It is
in Subic.
It's gonna be my first year of racing, so hopefully you guys will be there as I kick everybody's ass. Just kidding.
We look forward to it. Wow.
Okay guys, well, thank you for being our guest, and we're gonna watch, of course. Be safe out there, and for guys, grab their latest issue, Top Gear Philippines. It's on stand.
The green issue.
Yes.
Thank you for watching, guys. And don't worry, Joyce. We will grow our readers' attention spans to 20 minutes next time. So so that you can have more time.
Follow us on Instagram and Joyce also. Top Gear PH and
Joyce Spring.
And also, if you don't have time to watch this on our website, catch this on podcast.ph. Thank you, guys.